Ciao, ciao. Welcome back to the City Ash Show with me, James Horncastle. Today we'll be looking back at a selection of games from the weekend's action in City A. If you want to skip ahead to any section, you can do so by clicking over there. We'll also be focusing on some of the set piece chicanery in City A this season. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to the Guardian YouTube channel yet, you can do so by clicking on the G. But with that, let's get started. Andiamo. Juventus' win at the weekend was their biggest in 31 years, and like against Ascoli in 1983, when Michel Platini, Paolo Rossi and Domenico Penza all got braces, so too did Fernando Llorente, Alvaro Morata and Carlos Tevez in their 7-0 shellacking of Parma. Tevez, wearing the blue and yellow of Turin, looked like he was back at Boca, and he scored the goal of the weekend. It was reminiscent of Maradona against England, Ronaldo against Compostela, probably more like Eder against Fiorentina last weekend, or Adriano against Udinese a few years ago. Juventus were playing a new system, and a festive one too, a Christmas tree, and there are several presents beneath it. Max Allegri has been very sensible. He's bided his time. He's now picked his moment. He's moving on from Conte's 3-5-2. Could this be the catalyst that sees Juventus realise their potential in Europe? Well, on the continent, they'll face harder opposition than Parma. They've got the worst defence in Serie A. They've shipped 28 goals. That's more than anyone else in Europe's top five leagues. And they're back at the bottom of the table. Hernan Crespo's shadow looms large over Roberto Donadoni. And there's also talk of a takeover by an Albanian oil baron who has links to Milan. So watch this space. There's a lot going on at the Tardini. The Pharaoh finally made his goal drought ancient history. Stephen El-Shaarawy scored his first Serie A goal for 622 days in Milan's 2-2 draw with Sampdoria on Saturday night. He fell to the floor and broke down in tears. It meant so much to him. Meanwhile, Roma blitzed Torino 3-0. Adam Ljajic scored the pick of the bunch, silencing the newspaper men who claim he's on his way out of the club in January. But the big news, if we discount Francesco Totti not taking too kindly to his substitution by Rudy Garcia, was the return of Kevin Strootman. He's back after 8 months out with a knee ligament injury. Roma are going to ease him back into the squad over the next month. I think it's a preposterous idea that he will leave in January on loan to Manchester United, as has been reported. Their owner, Jim Pilotta, calling those reports not worth the paper they're printed on. Also, Napoli, well, they're getting closer to Roma now. They're on the podium in third place after their win against Fiorentina, but there was some bad news for them. Lorenzo Insigne, who's been in such great form for them in recent weeks, also suffered a knee ligament injury. Now he'll be out for 4 to 6 months. So on behalf of all of us here, guarisci presto, Lorenzo. Get well soon. Former Inter goalkeeper Gianluca Pagliuca is the only player to have saved more penalties in Serie A history than Samir Handanovic. His stop from Luca Toni from the spot on Sunday was the 20th of his career, and it came on a day when Genoa's Mattia Pirin and also Udinese's Orestis Karnazes also made saves from 12 yards. Incidentally, 13 penalties have been saved in Serie A this season. It's getting harder and harder to score from the spot. However, Handanovic's wasn't enough for Inter to clinch victory over Verona. Nico Lopez scored an equaliser 5 minutes from time. Whistles came down from the Curva Nord at San Siro. Mario Icardi said it's like playing away from home these days at the Giuseppe Meazza. The pressure mounts on Walter Mazzarri, partly because he was derided for blaming the rain to an extent for the draw. He's a Wally without a Broly at this moment in time. He looks like being on the brink of the sack for the first time in his career. Remember, he's never been sacked before. Inter's owner, Eric Tohir, met with the former honorary president, Massimo Moratti, to discuss his future on Monday. It doesn't look good for him, but Inter in a tricky spot because do they sack him now and give a new coach 2 weeks before the next round of fixtures? Stefano Vecchi, the youth team coach, has been mentioned, as have Leonardo and Roberto Mancini. Or do they wait until after the Derby della Madonnina and that trip to Roma to dismiss him? Walter Mazzarri could still save himself, but it doesn't look good. So watch this space. He's the lowest paid coach in the league and finally deservedly reached Serie A for the first time this summer at the age of 55. Empoli coach Maurizio Sarri is a great story. Take, for example, last Sunday when his Empoli team beat in-form Lazio 2-1. The Tuscans scored both goals from set pieces. Now, Sarri has a bit of a reputation. He's a former bank employee, smokes like a chimney like Zenit Zeman. He plays good football and launches young players like Zenit Zeman. He likes Charles Bukowski, and he also apparently has 33 different schemes from set pieces. He hates it when people bring that up, But when Empoli have scored 66.7% of their goals this season from those situations, you can't really blame us. 8 of their 12 goals have come from set pieces. Only Samp have scored as many. And they're coming up with really clever and novel routines using screens and blocks that you usually see in the NFL. Check out, for example, Manuel Pucciarelli's goal for Empoli against Milan, and also Manolo Gabbiadini's for Samp. Incidentally, Milan also headhunted a set-piece guru this summer from Fiorentina, Gianni Vio, who, like Sarri, also used to work in a bank, and it was whilst he was there that he published a book called Set Pieces, The 15-Goal Striker. Walter Zenger, well, he read it and he was so impressed, he appointed Vio as his set-piece specialist at Catania. Mihailovic worked with him there, so too did Montella, who then took him to Fiorentina. And his most famous routine was a few years back when Catania played Torino and Gianvito Plasmati pulled down his shorts, surprising the goalkeeper Matteo Sereni, and they scored. So Serie A isn't just a place for tactical innovation, it's also a place where set pieces can be really surprising and sophisticated. So those are my talking points. Let me know what yours are in the comments below. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to our Guardian YouTube channel yet, you can do so by clicking right there. There are also other videos on the channel from Andy Brassel on La Liga, from Raphael Honigstein on the Bundesliga, and Julien Laurens on Ligue 1. We'll be back after the international break, so why not check back with me then? Ciao for now.